The BMW i3 electric car is changing the way that cars are engineered and manufactured. And the biggest game changer is how the body structure is made of carbon fiber. Not only is this the first carbon fiber car in volume production, it could represent a turning point for the automotive industry.
The carbon fiber body is perfect. You could never get this with steel or aluminum.
But exactly how did BMW design this vehicle? What engineering hurdles did they overcome? Which innovations did they pioneer? Which suppliers did they use? And what does this car cost to make? That's exactly what Monroe & Associates set out to discover. It specializes in product teardowns that are far more detailed than anyone else provides. And it found some fascinating details in its teardown of the BMW i3. Monroe found that the attachment points for the body panels are actually glued onto the structure of the car. This allows BMW to completely change the styling of the i3 without having to modify any part of the structure. And that could allow the company to change the styling more quickly than its competitors. Monroe & Associates also found that the body structure is built in a mold to ensure precise dimensions. And all the holes are cut by water jet, so line workers never have to change drill bits, since carbon fiber can wear out bits in a very short time. Interestingly, the rear frame rails are actually one large die casting with integrated attachment points, right down to having the engine and suspension bushings pressed into place.
These castings help eliminate brackets and additional parts and components that typically get assembled to the body.
One of the toughest crash tests in the industry today is what they call the small overlap test. All automakers are struggling to meet it. But BMW took a very different approach with the i3. It added this hook, or initiator, onto the front suspension members. When the car hits the small overlap barrier, it also hits the initiator, which breaks off the head of the bolt holding the front suspension in place. That pivots the front wheel away from the car, preventing it from intruding into the passenger compartment. And the front bumper has these serrations that bite into the front frame rail during the small overlap crash test. It's a very simple solution that eliminates the need for additional brackets or structure. Most liftgates today are made of steel or aluminum or composite. But on the i3, BMW uses a combination of materials. While the liftgate is primarily one large molded composite piece, aluminum brackets are glued in specific places to support the backlight and the attachment points where the door latch is. The full details of the teardown report are available from Monroe & Associates. Automakers, suppliers, research labs, and others can buy the full report or select from reports on specific systems and subsystems. For more details on how you can purchase this groundbreaking analysis of one of the most innovative new cars ever designed, visit the website www.leandesign.com and order your copy today.